Greetings and happy Monday to everyone. It's hard to believe that here we are midway through the course, which just astounds me when that happens because it just flies by. I guess because we're just having so much fun. I'm going to send the announcement this week with this video just so you guys will have some more information. I've been embedding them in the week one during the introductions of the week, and so I'm just going to mix it up a little bit this week and have this in the announcement, and I'll shoot it out to you just so we can talk about, or I can talk about, what's going to happen in module four, because we're going to talk about communication and how important it is with communication. So I'll do a lecture on the functions of communication, then a lecture on organizational communication. There'll be a little short video about boomers and millennials. It's just kind of silly, but it does get the point across. And then a video on nonverbal communication. It's a TED Talk, and I like this and enjoy it, and it's just good information for you guys to have. And then there are no discussion posts this week, and before you go, yay, that's wonderful, there is a paper. So I do require a paper, and you can get details about it in the syllabus, but it's a paper increasing your awareness of nonverbal communication. And so what you're going to have to do is spend a couple days, so that's one reason I did this video, so hopefully you'll see it, but just consider and look at people, just look at their nonverbal cues, look at trying to understand. You're going to be the listener, and you may, you know, it's your casual conversation, group discussions. If you're in a formal meeting, that's a good place, but I know a lot of times these days you're not back in formal meetings. But I want you to just look at what people are doing nonverbally, like the loss of eye contact with the speaker, their posture, facial expression, hand motions. You know, my mother would always say, I can't talk unless I'm using my hands. And just take note of that and what's going on. And then I want you to concentrate on yourself and think about, take note of the nonverbal behavior that others directed you when you're talking. And so after each encounter, kind of look at that. But it's just really a way for you as an exercise to become more aware of what's going on nonverbally. And then if you know that, then you can pay more attention to responding to nonverbal messages that you receive. So with your paper, just compose it to where you're discussing your experiences, note the nonverbal cues of others, and really the nonverbal cues that you might give off. You may not even realize that you're not paying attention to people, or that you look off, or you look down, or you, I don't know, twirl your hair, or you do something. But your paper needs to be 3 pages in length, 12-point font. I do ask for that, but just, I'm older, it's just easier for me to read if it's 12-point. And then you're willing, you know, you can research it, but this is not a research paper. But what it is your reflections on how you view and how you notice nonverbal communication. So anyway, that's just the instructions for this week. If you've got any questions, please just shoot me an email. I'll be happy to answer them. I'll try to have your papers graded, or not papers, but have your discussion posts graded by midweek and have those up. But other than that, that's pretty much it. One other point. Remember that we have our Zoom meeting, and that's next Monday night, I believe, excuse me, as I look on my calendar, June 28th at 6:30, and I'll get a Zoom link out to you. And it won't take probably 45 minutes, tops an hour, but we will be discussing and going over. I'll give a lecture on Zoom meetings and just show you a couple tricks when it comes to Zoom of what you can do, because we're going to move into the virtual part of it, and I'll start assigning groups. What I try to do is have that first meeting, kind of see how everybody participates, and then I'll assign teams. More than likely, I'm pretty sure I'll just do 2 teams. So you'll be split into a virtual team, and then you guys are going to have to meet and come up with meetings a couple times on your own without me there, and schedule it and get together. If you're interested in being a team leader, let me know. I have a goodie for you if you do that. I can't help you on giving extra credit, but there might be a reward in there for you in forms of a gift. How's that? A small gift. But think about it. If you're willing to be a team leader, just shoot me a message and say, hey, you know, I'll be happy to be a team leader. But you guys have a good one. Again, if you have questions, shoot me an email and I'll be happy to help you. But have a great one, and I'll be back in touch later in the week. Bye.